It's one of the first all-in-one VR headsets to come to market. It's the £199 Oculus Go. So the headline feature of the Oculus Go is that it's completely wireless. You no longer need a smartphone or a PC to power the headset, it's all built in. Now this makes VR instantly more accessible to the masses because you no longer need a £500 smartphone or a £1,500 PC to power the VR. Just pop the headset on and you're there. Oh, and don't worry about if you wear glasses, it comes with a glasses spacer in the box. One area where the Oculus Go trumps even the Oculus Rift is the display. Inside the headset, you'll find a 5.5-inch fast switch LCD display. That's a higher resolution than the Oculus Rift and a change in display tech too. The fast switch display tech negates screen door effect to a level where it's barely noticeable, and that's still a prevalent issue in high-end VR headsets. Another cool feature of the Oculus Go is in the audio department because even though it provides spatial audio, it doesn't need headphones. Now this is interesting because the speakers are on either side of the headset beneath these arms here. That's where the audio is produced, which is then reverberated down each arm and projected into your ears.
The Oculus Go features a made-for-VR Snapdragon 821 chipset that handles all the tracking, powers the display, and generally provides the virtual magic. Though it's not Qualcomm's most powerful chipset, it was designed with VR in mind and has been optimized to provide a great all-round VR experience.
With all that tech built into the headset, it's going to be bulky and heavy, right? Wrong. It's actually one of the most comfortable headsets we've used to date. That's due to a more ergonomically shaped facial surround, which is also a lot softer than what you'll get from your rivals. That's combined with more breathable materials that will help you stay cool in the VR. And that's been combined with a brand new strap system, which you might notice has a gap at the back for ponytails. And you can also remove the top strap completely if your hair is large. So how do you interact with the virtual world around you? You'll be using the Oculus controller. Those that have used Gear VR might recognize the design because it's based on the controller for that, but it's more ergonomically shaped and more comfortable to use.
Much like the VR headset, the controller offers 3 degrees of freedom, meaning that you can rotate it, but it won't sense depth or motion.
Now, what's the difference? It basically means that the Oculus Go will track your head movement. You can look up, look down, look behind you, look around you. But if you move forward or you kneel down or you jump in the air, none of that will be tracked.
But as all games and apps on the Oculus Store have been designed with this in mind, you don't really feel like you're missing out on anything. The focus for Oculus with the Go is on entertainment and social, and the selection of apps on offer reflects that, with over 1,000 apps and games available to download. These range from the likes of Netflix that allows you to watch your favourite shows in a virtual cabin in the mountains, to social apps like Oculus Home, and even 360-degree documentaries like those provided from within.
But despite the focus on entertainment and social, the Oculus Go does have a wide library of games available to play. And on the plus side, many of them are cheaper than they are for the Rift.
The Oculus Go features a built-in rechargeable battery that provides around 2 hours of charge before it needs a top-up, though that may slightly vary depending on what you're doing. Overall, the Oculus Go has the potential to really show the masses what VR can do. While smartphone-powered VR has always been the go-to, the Oculus Go provides a much better overall experience in a nice, simple package that requires no smartphone or PC to work. And despite all the tech being crammed into the headset, it's still sleek, lightweight, and comfortable to wear over long periods.
All that for under £200? This really could be Oculus's star product.